people do use their emotions strategically, and some people are better at this than others. But the question is, who are these people? All our lives we've been trained to read emotions in others. We use this in lots of everyday interactions, for example, to detect if someone is angry, because that enables us to react to that and correct our mistakes. So the question of our research was whether people use the expression of their emotions strategically. To study this question, my co-authors and I designed a laboratory experiment. We invited participants to come to our laboratory, where we assigned them the role of either being a manager or being a worker. The managers had to decide who of the workers would get assigned a certain task. Some of these tasks were nice tasks, for example, going on a nice business trip. Other tasks were not so nice, for example, like controlling paperwork. Before the managers could decide who would get what kind of task, they saw a photograph of these workers. Around 200 participants played in the role of workers and decided what kind of photograph to send to their boss. Using emotion detection software, we observed that people send indeed a happy photograph when they want to be selected and send an angry photograph when they do not want to get selected. So our results show that not necessarily IQ or strategic thinking are important for this behavior, but that other skills, for example, emotional intelligence is important. From this study, we learned that people are indeed very much influenced by the expressions of emotions in others. And some people try to use that to their advantage. Now, of course, it's easier to influence your emotion expressions on photographs than in face-to-face interactions. This research was made possible through the support of the Toulouse School of Economics and the Institute for Advanced Studies in Toulouse, which is an interdisciplinary research center in Toulouse. And of course, also through the help of the ANR, the French National Research Agency.